You got like an in-game hour and 20 minutes to get over to the Digifirewood and stuff. We can go a little bit over that if we need to. They don't have to go to sleep immediately when the game is like, hey, go to sleep. Cut it out. But I would like to get there before then. Got info on Blue Marimon, which is kind of pointless because I know I'm already guaranteed to get Blue Marimon. But alright, let's go do this. I need info for Mega Seedramon more than anything else. Although he's apparently already fixed for Metal Seedramon or whatever that mystery Digimon is. Like, I don't see how it could... I can go to the hinterland of Faulty Ex Machina, that's good. I don't see how it could be anything other than Metal Seedramon, but we'll see. Something else you may have noticed is that this past weekend, this is going up on Monday, I believe. Should be. This past weekend, Saturday and Sunday, there were only 3 videos each of those days rather than the usual 6. I had a really busy weekend, is basically all I can say to that. My spring break had ended. I was coming back to classes. Professors were like, hey, any projects you did over spring break, time to start turning them in. That's how, like, a couple of my professors were. A couple of other professors were like, hey, I hope you enjoyed spring break. It's time to start taking tests and projects and stuff. And so, stuff like that got thrown on. Basically, it was just really busy. That and other stuff with the TBU, which if you don't know what the TBU is, it's a Pokemon League that I am the administrator of, so had some stuff going on with it. It was actually pretty slow this week, but I did have to get a couple of things done. Please just let all these things die instantly. I hate... Something that I would like to suggest, if they ever make another Digimon World game, which I hope they do, because I do enjoy Digimon World, even though there are definitely some aspects of it that I don't like, the camera. Like, I mess around with it every now and then, switching it off of dynamic and onto dynamic, but no matter what, like, there's always the possibility of ambient stuff getting in the way and making it difficult to see when your Digimon are making contact and stuff. And I just don't like it, man. I don't think there's a way to have a static camera in this game unless I'm just unaware of it. I want to be able to have a static camera. I'd like to be able to, like, switch the camera from being static and dynamic instead of... Or, well, it switches from dynamic to normal, I guess is what it's called, but it doesn't switch to static because no matter which version it's on, it still moves around. And sometimes the background gets in the way of the camera. That house at the Meaty Troops place in front of what's-his-face, in front of Tyrannomon, is the perfect example. And it makes it where sometimes you just cannot see the battlefield. And I'm pretty sure you can still see the numbers of when damage makes contact, so you can kind of use that to figure out, like, when you need to press X. But I think overall, it's just a lot easier to time that if you can actually see the battle. I basically hate this. I need you to stop chasing me. I don't want to fight all of you at once. How many did I get at once? 3? Let's try it. I like how Mega Seedramon, like, dropped out of the sky and just dropped a waterfall on him for some reason. If I could immediately get a Lightning Javelin, that would be wonderful right there. Go, kill something right now. I forgot we had Third Order now, so... Oh, wow, Mega Seedramon, how'd you get so low on HP? We have Third Order now, so that's good. Bad news is, though, we're starting to run low on recovery discs, and I'm really low on cash. Don't really have the money to be going around buying more. Please just land some kind of mega crit against these guys and insta-kill them. I would really appreciate it. Yeah, we're like... This is such a drastic change from, like, it wasn't even long ago that we had, I didn't mean to use your middle move. I pressed down and left on the freaking controller, but I guess the game didn't care for some reason, which is really lame, but, you know, whatever. Anyways, this is such a drastic decrease from the amount of strength we had when we had Eximon. Just Eximon, not even, like, Eximon and Shine Greymon, just flat out having Eximon alone. What's your... Gradually recovers MP, increase max HP and recover half. May as well use it before the battle ends. I was hoping that's the ability that Mega Seedramon had, but no such luck. And there's still 2 more of these Yokomon wandering around. I didn't kill them all. Just give me this. I don't care about getting the stone over there. I just want these materials. I really hope that A, we get some red Digizoid. Dang it. and B, that the tint is at maximum durability. It's at 2, which is good enough for me. I'll take that. Give you some tamer experience. Big amount. 162 is basically nothing. But whatever.
Good night. Sleep tight.
I really hope that by... What's happening? Is someone digivolving? Oh, you're digivolving into Blue Marimon. Alright, so we got 2 ultimates at the same time. That's alright, I guess. Blue Marimon, how did Chaos call it? How could he have possibly have known? Oh gee, I wonder. Doesn't Blue Marimon have the really defined buttocks? Yeah, he does. These Yokomon are gonna catch me, and I'm honestly just gonna run away from them, because I don't care and I can't be bothered. Actually, no. It is 3 of them. I was about to say, if it's only 1 or 2 of them, I'll take them on, but I can't be bothered, honestly. Do I look like I have the time to be putting up these Yokomon? You can't see me right now, but let me assure you, I do not look like I have the time to be putting up with these Yokomon. Yeah, stay away from them, man. Give me all this digi-bamboo. Could come in really handy. Gimme. A lot? 1 in 5, I'll take that. 5 digi-firewood? I think digi-firewood is what we need to level up the Digivolution Dojo next, so... It actually is really worth going through the trouble of trying to doing this whole scenario of going there, getting the materials, sleeping, picking up the materials again, because Digi-Firewood is just that useful at the moment. If it is what I think. Yes, we need a lot more Digi-Light and only 19 more Digi-Firewood. We already have enough Digi-Fellwood. So we're not even that. I don't know what the next level up for the Digivolution Dojo does for us in terms of Digivolution, but I can only imagine it's good, so... It actually would be really worth our while to try and get that try and put some focus into getting that Digi-Light and the Digi-Firewood. Now, I think we've got a couple of best meats on hand, and we're about to get another, 8 from the field here. So let's grab this stuff and then go over and sell it and get a good amount of cash, and then look at the stock market and hope and pray that it's actually decent today. I don't understand how we got to this point, I'll be honest with you. We've somehow gotten into this horrible rut of our Digimon dying at the worst possible times, so they're incredibly weak right now, more so than I would expect them to be after being rebirthed. Especially because I have all the rebirth bonuses, too, and I have 3 of the 4 Digivolution bonuses. But, on top of that, we're also, out of money, and the stock market is set up perfectly to where it's like, hey... Good luck getting any money off of this anytime soon. Man, you're gonna be waiting a while. The pot never goes up in price, even though you're maxed out on pots right now. Why do I have these? I was gonna use these for someone. I have 24 best meat. That's gonna be a good amount of cash. Yeah, 12K. It's pretty good. Go ahead and sell these because I can. And the 1 remedy disc, and the 3 recovery, and the 3 MP, and the 2 medium, and the other 2, or the 4 medium here. I'm debating with myself internally right now. Do I want to buy more recovery items or try to save cash to be able to level up another of the trading facilities? Because we only have 3 more to go, I think. Speed, the other thing. Can the pot, it is going up in price, but can it go up a little faster? And can the other things please drop instead of consistently rising? I would really appreciate it. Anyways, I was debating if... You know what? I'm going to use... How much info do I have on Blue Marimon? We could get Mirage Galgamon again. We can actually get Gankumon. Gankumon is within reach if his stats only need to be around 1,400. Could get Leviamon. That would take a little more effort, though. You know what? Mega Seedramon is fixed on this Digivolution, which I'm 80% sure is Metal Seedramon. Scratch that. 98% sure. I should have said that to start. I'm going to use all of these Bomber Nannymon items on Blue Marimon and see what we can get. I didn't even read what that was. I probably should have, though. I was just pressing X so fast, come on, get me through this. This time we got Mirage Galgamon's weight. That's good. I think we're just going to go for Mirage Galgamon again. Because Mirage Galgamon was really easy to get before, and I want Mirage Galgamon. Leviamon's wisdom. Wait a minute. How much does Leviamon's wisdom take? I would love to have Leviamon. Leviamon's wisdom is inconsequential. Under 49, speed over 1300. We can, like, get to the requirements of Mirage Galgamon really easily. Let's just leave everything open for now. And we'll look about possibly blocking off Mirage Galgamon to try and get Leviamon later. Because we have had Mirage Galgamon before, but it's been so long since we had Mirage Galgamon. That was like the first Mega we got, if I'm not mistaken. Look at how horrible Blue Marimon's stats are outside of his HP and MP, which are actually pretty good for an ultimate. It's so bad. I don't understand how my Digimon... And they get so little... They get like nothing from stat training. Like, literally nothing. Plus 24 is basically worthless. Like, why even bother? How much do you... This is gonna give, like, any worthwhile points? Like, look at that. Plus 20. It's not even worth training. I don't understand how this happened. Man, I gotta figure out something. We can't just sit here. It's gonna take... I'm gonna be trading them until they die, basically. There's gotta be a good location to go to. How much is Leviamon's speed? I don't understand. I remember sometimes the training halls were normally given, like, it would give rookies, like, plus 100, and I thought champions were still getting, like, plus 50. You get to ultimates and they only give plus 20 per? That's just not even worth. There's no point in using it at that point. No point in using it at that point. Yeah, that's how words work. I basically just hate the situation we've somehow found ourselves in. I don't know, man. The Pedomon were, like, on par with us. Where's somewhere I can go to try and get some quick stats? I don't even know. What was before the upper level of Logi Volcano in terms of the game? I think the Wastelands? The Wastelands were after Logi Volcano, but you only went, like, halfway up Logi Volcano. You didn't go all the way up. You choose to do that on your own time later.
Here you go.
I don't know. Let's go to the Wastelands and see if we can fight the Digimon there on an even level. And maybe start getting stat boosts from them. Let's go see how this goes. I've got to figure out something. Something has to be done. I might have to just finally bite the bullet and do stuff off screen, which I've avoided doing for almost the entire playthrough. I'm pretty sure the only time I ever did anything on screen. I'm hoping for some Digi Sand and Digi Light here, by the way, but no such luck. I'm pretty sure I only did things off screen once. I took one in-game day to go and just grind up fighting the Pedomon, and I got a lot of bit from it and a lot of medicine and bandages to sell, and it helped us pay for like two level ups in the training facilities, if I'm not mistaken, or something similar to that. Other than that, I haven't done anything off screen. Like, every single Digivolution that has ever happened when I've played this game has been in a video. And I really want to keep it that way, but I'm sitting here thinking, like, with how slow this is going, we might have, like, another three sessions of this. And that's just, like, I can't do that. That's no fun. That's not an enjoyable video to watch, in my eyes. You know what I forgot to do? Nice. I forgot to look at What's-His-Face's moves, which I should have done. I pressed that way too early, but whatever. I like how we got a fire and ice combo attack. That's pretty sick.
Nice and calm.
I also like how you missed that bubble breath somehow. Look at how much damage my boy Mega Seedramon is taking. This is ridiculous.
You did it.
Please, like, kill this thing in one go with Lightning Javelin. Bam. Please die. It absolutely chewed it. Like, why do I even try anymore? This'll finish it, though. But what kind of stat boosts am I gonna get from this? Let's see how that goes. We were able to win this fight pretty easily, you know, only fighting a singular Vegemon. See, this is, like, only slightly better than the 45 Tamer experience in 240 bit is a really good bonus, but the amount of stat increases we got from that is only just slightly better than the training hall. if even. I still only got, like, plus 20. I mean, it takes... And actually, technically speaking, it... How do I phrase this? It takes less in-game time, because time freezes when you're in these battles. So, I get more time for my Digimon's lifespan and all, but it takes even longer in, like, video IRL time. Like, in my actual, like human time. It takes even longer. To be honest with you, like, my real-life time and the video time is way more important to me than the in-game time. I'd rather waste more in-game time than anything else. Thank goodness this thing is dead now, though. Man, I don't know, dude. I just don't know what to do. I can still talk with this Shamamon? Why have you not joined the town yet? Oh, hello, what is it? The meaty veggie war is over, but a new enemy may surface. I'll stay here and stand guard. Well, okay, then. This sucks, man. Like, we're just in such a crappy situation. I wonder if it would be good. Because we have, I think it's Goblimon who will sell us devil chips, or there's someone who will sell us devil chips, because someone was telling me about this in comments. They were like, hey, Chaos, if you, like, want to get your Digimon put together, like, to be on the same level, which they are right now, I don't know how it happened, but they're both ultimates. But the guy was basically telling me, like, hey, if you want to, like, try and even out your Digimon to where you've got champions at the same time and megas at the same time, etc., so you don't have to have, like, an ultimate around when you're trying to train up a rookie, then use devil chips to get your Digimon to die sooner. He told me who I could get the chips from. I just don't remember who it was off the top of my head. But I definitely don't want to do that. I'd rather have a Digimon higher leveled, because that's part of the problem right now, is these guys are at the same level. If one of them was higher leveled, then we could go fight stronger stuff, and the one who was lower leveled would level up way faster. He'd get... Well, there's no leveling system for us in this game, but you know what I mean. He'd get stats way faster, which would be incredibly useful right now. Instead, they're both at the same level and having to fight the same level of the enemies, which are around their level and do not give as much experience, which is really unfortunate. I hate how, like, frail. That's the word. I hate how frail Mega Seedramon seems to be. He gets hurt way too easily. But I wonder if it would be better to just kill these guys off. Like, block off all of their possible digivolutions so they can't digivolve. And then, let them die and restart from scratch and see if I can make that work. Or make one of them die and then, when it becomes an in-training, like, go and do the stat grinding, process I was told and see if that could just boost them way up. Because maybe it's just because of the time that they digivolved. Like, they digivolved at an unfortunate time or something, and it's kind of, something has screwed with the entire system and made this way more difficult than it should be. I don't know. All I know is that I've just recorded two videos worth of 40 minutes, and we've made, like, no actual progress, which I hate. I hate not making progress. I'm going to give you a little bit of HP. And by a little bit, I mean 5,000. Yeah, I hate not making progress in these videos. It just feels like a waste of time. So I think I'm finally going to have to... What was the phrase I used earlier? Bite the bullet. And do stuff off screen. I just really, really don't want to get a Mega Digivolution off screen. That's the main thing. If it was like, if something had just been reborn, and I got like, I got, I like restarted and I got Coromon, and then I got Coromon to Digivolve up to Greymon. I wouldn't mind if you guys didn't see Agumon and Greymon Digivolving on screen, like... Really, I doubt many of you care, but I care. It means a lot to me that the Digivolutions are on screen. But I'm sure plenty of you are thinking, like, dude, what does it even freaking matter? We've seen several Digivolutions. They're all the same, just with a different Digimon sprite. So, just do the stuff off screen. But I don't like doing that, man. I like it all being on screen. I personally like to see stuff like the Digivolutions happen, which is why I like to make sure they're in the videos. Really, with a game that's so time-based like this one, I just want as much as possible to be on screen, really. But I think this might be a very rare, hopefully very rare, like never happens again scenario where I've just gotta... It's just that we had an unfortunate turn of events, and I have to sit down for like 2 hours to grind out stats and stuff to fix this. Like, it's just a matter of, like, a mistake. I made a mistake somewhere. I don't know what mistake I made or how I made it. I also wanted to look at my skills really fast. Oh, man. Yeah, we're getting Material Master next. I'm saving up for Material Master now. I'm also probably going to get a lot of Tamer experience and some Tamer level ups and stuff. But I don't know. Maybe I just need to kill them. Let them die out. And then restart fresh. And then be smarter about it when they restart. I need only one of them to do that, though. I need one of them to die. But they're both on the road to becoming, like, Mirage Galgamon. His stat requirements are very low. I'm positive Blue Marimon will be able to digivolve into Mirage Galgamon. And Mega Seedramon already has a fix label on the Mystery Digimon that is not Metal Seedramon, obviously. So they're both definitely going to make it to Mega. Let me look at your stats again. Now, your stats even aren't that horrible. They're both over 1,000. Mega Seedramon here's got 1,400 in Wisdom and Strength. I just don't understand why training facilities are giving so little in way of stats. They normally give a lot more than that, I thought. I don't understand why they're doing so poorly.